We've recently released CamTrackAR, our first iOS app that uses AR tech to track your scene as you film on your iPhone. Today, we're going over the basics and showing you how to get the best results with CamTrackAR. We have had such a positive response from CamTrackAR, and people are using it to create all kinds of cool content. So to help out, here's a look at how to get started and some top tips for getting the best track possible. Since release, we've added a couple of new features, so if you're wanting to follow along, be sure to grab the latest update, and don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss any of our future videos. Let's first take you through the UI. Opening the app, you'll be greeted by the recording setup. Immediately, CamTrack begins scanning your scene for surfaces. In the top left of the display, the status will be updated until the track is built. This will be displayed by the dark blue grid on surfaces. Once it's level, the floor plane icon in the bottom right corner will shift to green, and hitting this will lock the floor in place. And the record button on your right is now active and ready to go. Depending on what you're filming, you may want to disable the autofocus to prevent it from jumping between different subjects. Be sure to have your subject in focus, then tap the icon in the bottom left to disable. Retap to enable again. You're now set to place an anchor in your scene. Moving along the surface is a green 2x2 target. Point this target at an area you want to mark and hit the anchor icon, which is located below the record button. If you place this inaccurately, you might want to move the anchor. Place the target over the anchor and hit the icon once again. Those on the subscription or pro version of CamTrackAR will have access to multiple anchor placements. Here are some tips for getting the best results during capture. Consider your environment. On the whole, CamTrackAR works better indoors than it does outside. If you need to be outside, be sure to get a flat surface like a road or a pathway to begin the scan. Keep it light. Exposure can also affect the track, so make sure your scene is well lit and not kept in the shadows. This will also affect how secure your anchors are in the scene. Texture and depth. ARKit finds it difficult to detect surfaces that have no texture, like white walls or mirrors. However, newer devices with LiDAR technology can handle this better. Scan the scene. You should take some time to scan your location before you start putting anchors down, instead of putting them as you explore. This will give CamTrackAR a better understanding of your environment and extend your floor plane. When recording is completed, a pop-up will notify you of the files created and their location on your phone, with an option to continue filming or go to the files directly. These are stored in the CamTrackAR folders in the Files application. They're named after the date and time of the recording. Every export will include a HitFilm composite file, a Blender Python script, and your footage. If you've got either the Pro or subscription plans, then you'll also have the .jsx, .csv, .json, and possibly more coming soon. To move the files onto your PC or Mac, either share the folder via email, store online with iCloud or Google Drive accounts, or transfer over iTunes. Now you have your footage and files, let me show you how to import and use this data. Timecodes for your compositor of choice can be found in the description. First up is, of course, HitFilm. Now, of course, we had to give you guys the easiest approach. All you need to do is open your HitFilm composite shot or import into an existing project, and your scene will be opened and ready with any anchors converted to point layers. Just import and drag in your footage if you're using it. Be sure to set any assets to 3D and parent them to the corresponding point. Reset the position and they will snap to that spot in the scene. You can then unparent them if you want. Now you're all set and ready to go. Now we'll show you how to import into Blender. In your recording output folder, we've provided a Python script. This script is a HitFilm composite shot importer. You'll need to install this for your Blender project. You can do this by going into the Edit tab, down to Preferences, and entering the Add-ons option. Now hit the Install button at the top of the window, go to where you saved your data files, and import the Blender HitFilm importer add-on. You can now import HitFilm composite shots as you would footage, models, and other motion data. File, Import, and select the HitFilm composite shot option. Your camera, floor plan, and markers are now all set. Let's take a look at how to import into After Effects. If you have the Pro or subscription, you'll be given access to a .jsx file. This is suitable for importing into Adobe After Effects. This import is really simple. Go into the File menu and make your way down to Scripts. You'll then want to select the top option, Run Script File. Find your .jsx file where you saved your output folder, and hit Open. A composite shot is created for your project. And finally, the .csv format. If you see yourself as a developer and want to create your own tools, in the Pro and subscription bundles, we offer a .csv file that can allow you to view the tracking data in your choice of reader. You can then use this data for your own projects and needs. Since CamTrackAR's release, we've been really excited to see what you guys have been creating using the app. And we can't wait to see what you make in the future now that you know these best practices. We'll be reposting our community's work on our Instagram, so be sure to follow and consider submitting your own work at FXhome_official. We want to know from you guys, what are you most excited to create using CamTrackAR? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching, be sure to subscribe for more in the future, and we'll see you all in the next video.